So, since I finally got Audacity up and running, and now that I know that it's not a virus, I thought I would make a little special video for you all. I am recording this audio at, 4:06 p.m. I hope I can get it done in, I don't know how long this video is actually going to be, but I hope it's good. I hope you all like it. I basically put my heart and soul into this thing. So, anyway, here we go. Also, I recommend you wear headphones for the best experience, audio-wise, and that you watch this at, 4K or 1080p. Anyway, yeah. So, in terms of today's video, what I want to talk about is, what should some video ideas be? I don't know, maybe something like, actually, maybe that would work. Oh yeah, how they flanderized Shadow's character. Ah yes, so the people think that, it all started with Adventure 2, right? So, Shadow was portrayed pretty well in this game, I would say. The whole thing about him not remembering what Maria truly said before, she released him down in that capsule, down to Earth. And then, because of that, he steals the Green Chaos Emerald from a jewelry store. And then, then Sonic confronts him after going through City Escape and fighting Bigfoot. And so, then they kind of, intersect, and then he realizes he can do Chaos Control. Sonic gets arrested by the military, etc. And then the story just goes on as normal. But honestly, in that moment, I can see a lot of his personality shine through that I don't think a lot of people talk about. Honestly, that has got to be my favorite scene in Adventure 2 just for that reason alone. Just the effort that's put into making these characters feel right in their first interaction. It's and the fact that Shadow is always above Sonic somehow, in any of these scenes, it just feels right. Shadow knows that Sonic wouldn't stand a chance against him, but then after, the Bio Lizard and they, or, well, more so Final Hazard, and they defeat Final Hazard, he sort of, during that fight, he sort of treats Sonic like a comrade, and then he falls to Earth. But then after that, the whole thing about in Heroes, where he got rescued by Eggman, which was revealed in Shadow's ending level if you wait for 9 minutes, which is absurd. But anyway, basically that happened, and then it basically, I don't know, there wasn't really much progress made. It was just them searching around for clues to his past. And then in Shadow the Hedgehog, the game I mentioned before, there isn't, it feels they flanderized him, because it's then they start going for this angle where it's the choose your own adventure. Do you, would Shadow be a hero or a villain based on your own, personal preferences in terms of story path? And it's I don't know how to feel about that, because it's isn't that choice kind of technically the gameplay choice of that like that element of it could be considered as like canonically in the game, it could be considered as Shadow like deciding what path he's going to take and what side he's going to take, because he can't remember anything. But in terms of a gameplay aspect, I don't know, man. It just didn't work. And then, I guess the only path I would say that is actually true is the hero path in terms of the canon ending. Or maybe it's the neutral path, either one of those. And then, obviously, the last story, and then you go to 06, where, you know, he works with Gunn even though they killed his best friend. That's... What? Did he just forget all that? But I don't know. I feel like it's for the better. Like, maybe it's like, oh, like, maybe what they were going for was like an, oh, you know, Shadow's made amends with them and has, like, moved past, you know, Maria's death and kind of, like, just moved on and forged his own path kind of thing. And now he works for the betterment of other people and to make sure they don't get caught up in the same situation as he once was with them. But after that, you know, it was a good arc. But after that, then it just kind of started to go down a hill, because in Generations, I guess, the reason why they fight him, the reason why they fight Sonic in Generations is, I guess, for story purposes, for callbacks and stuff like that, but for regular story purposes, it's more so, like, it would be, like, you know, it's like they think he's a fake. Like, both Shadow and Silver both say that when the actual fight comes up. So, yeah. And then, in, like, the next game we see him, because we don't see him in Lost World, which I found really odd. And then in Forces, he is majorly, majorly Flanderized. And even in the prequel comics, he just... Man, he doesn't... No. Hear me out. He doesn't, like... I guess what I'm trying to say here is he doesn't feel like himself in terms of characterization. He should see Sonic as a comrade, not an enemy. And it's like, with the whole fake stuff, and then, you know, Shadow kicks the fake. Well, and then it's basically revealed to Sonic that, you know, Infinite can make illusions of, like, past enemies and stuff like that. But that's never explained beyond that. It's like, I like the concept of it, but at the same time, in terms of Shadow's characterization, it doesn't help. Because in Episode Shadow, he literally calls Infinite worthless, and then apparently that's just the thing that starts off Infinite's character arc. And he's like always this, and in Forces, he's always like this brooding, kind of like Shadow, but even edgier. And even Infinite points out how Shadow is brooding in that cutscene. So I kind of just, I don't know, I feel like in terms of like Sonic's larger cast of characters, this is a major problem that they need to sort out. And I'm sure Ian Flynn has something planned for the larger cast of characters, because I hope they become relevant again. I really hope they do. I don't know why we didn't see like Blaze or Cream and Forces. Honestly, I think that was a super missed opportunity. And I honestly hope we get to see them again, along with, you know, Team Dark actually being considered canon, because Izuka decided to fuck with that too. I don't know why he did. He just did. But yeah, I feel like in terms of Shadow's characterization, it's kind of gone downhill. But in IDW, it's actually, I don't know. IDW Shadow is more like what Ian thinks Shadow is based on Forces. During the Metal Virus arc specifically, I do not feel bad for him because it was kind of his choice to get infected. And that's what kicks off, like, Sonic's fear of it. So, honestly, I don't know what to say there, aside from, you know, maybe they should try stepping away from that interpretation of Shadow and, like, try to rebuild his character like it was in Adventure 2, where he sees Sonic as a comrade and, you know, he's not really... He isn't a fake. Because, here's the thing. Gerald didn't design Sonic to be... Gerald didn't design Shadow to be a fake of Sonic. Because, dude, 2001! Because the game takes place on Earth, obviously it would take place in 2001. And we all know what happened then. But, like, 50 years before that was 1951, so... And Sonic wasn't alive then. Probably. So, I don't think that Gerald designed Shadow to be a copy of Sonic at all. Like, that's just... That doesn't make sense from a, like, an actual logical point of view that doesn't have any ground to stand on in terms of that claim. But, yeah, I really do hope that, you know, Shadow's character actually gets fixed in the next game he appears in. Because I really do want, you know, these characters to have, like, fleshed out, like, stories again. Like, Tales and Frontiers, you know, he goes through that SA1 arc again. I even had an argument about this with someone on Reddit. And I think they know who they are if they're watching this video. But they made the claim that the Japanese version does a better way of handling it. And, like, with him being, like, honestly, I see both points. Like, it's good, yeah. But in terms of, like, you know, me, I think both versions are fine in terms of that. In terms of, like, you know, Tails' characterization, I think the same lessons should be learned for Shadow as well. Kind of like an equivalent, I guess. Where it's like, they both go through, like, you know, revitalizing their character and, you know, kind of like realizing that they've been acting like super out of character in recent years, and then they kind of like build upon that to improve themselves as people. And I love the fact that Ian did that for Tails, and I hope he does the same for Shadow, because that would be nice. And since they mentioned Maria in the Frontiers, I guess it actually would make sense. So, yeah, I just wanted to make this little video essay just a video on this in general, because I finally got Audacity, and I realized it is not spyware, it is working fine. And I'm gonna probably edit this video now. Whenever it stops recording, also I have to kind of hit 15 minutes for ad revenue. But that's not a big deal. And that's more so just me being dumb. But anyway, yeah, that was just a little video about, like, you know, like a topic like this. This is unscripted, so I really don't know what to say. If I was stuttering anywhere, I'll try to, like, fix that. Because, honestly, I am horrible at public speaking, and I hate that I am. Even when I'm alone and doing this, I just feel weird because I'm talking to literally nothing. But anyway, yeah, I actually want to know, do you guys like and want to see this type of content more in the future? Because I think that would actually really help. This was sort of like a test video for like video essays in general, since I've never really done one before. So I hope this was done well in terms of that area. I don't really know how to structure them that well, but I will probably like mess around with it and just rearrange things if I want to. Like, yeah. Anyway, see ya. Also subscribe. Because yes. Also, I kind of have a stance against that, but I guess that would be like a separate video of mine. So yeah. See ya.